The Sikorsky H-5 was a helicopter built by Sikorsky Aircraft Corporation. It was used by the United States Air Force and its predecessor, the United States Army Air Forces, as well as the United States Navy and United States Coast Guard. It was also used by the United States Post Office Department. The civilian version, under the designation S-51, was the first helicopter to be operated commercially, commencing in 1946. In December 1946, an agreement was signed between the British company Westland Aircraft and Sikorsky to produce a British version of the H-5, to be manufactured under license in Britain as the Westland Sikorsky WS-51 Dragonfly. By the time production ceased in 1951, more than 300 examples of all types of the H-5 had been built. The H-5 was originally built by Sikorsky as its model S-48, designated as the R-5 by the United States Army Air Forces. It was designed to provide a helicopter having greater useful load, endurance, speed, and service ceiling than the Sikorsky R-4. In March 1944, the Army Air Forces ordered 26 Year-5 as for service testing, and in February 1945, the first YR-5A was delivered. Of these, 14 were the R-5A, basically identical with the YR-5A. The remaining 20 were built as the three-place R-5D, which had a widened cabin with a two-place rear bench seat and a small nose wheel added to the landing gear, and could be optionally fitted with a rescue hoist and an auxiliary external fuel tank. The United States Navy evaluated 3R5 as is the HO2S1. Sikorsky soon developed a modified version of the R5, the S-51, featuring a greater rotor diameter, greater carrying capacity and gross weight, and a redesigned tricycle landing gear configuration. This first flew on the 16th of February 1946. With room for 3 passengers plus pilot, the S-51 was initially intended to appeal to civilian as well as military operators, and was the first helicopter to be sold to a commercial user. 11 S-51s were ordered by the USAF and designated the R-5F, while 92 went to the Navy as the HO3S1, commonly referred to as the Horse. In Britain, Westland Aircraft began production in 1946 of the Westland Sikorsky S-51 Dragonfly for the Royal Navy and the Royal Air Force, all of which were powered by a 500-horsepower Alvis Leonids engine. In total, 133 Westland Sikorsky Dragonfly helicopters were built. The U.S. Navy ordered 4 S-51s, off the shelf, from Sikorsky in late 1946 for use in the Antarctic and Operation High Jump, placing them into naval inventory as the HO3S1. Carried aboard the seaplane tender USS Pine Island, on Christmas Day 1946 an HO3S1 of VX-3 piloted by Lieutenant Commander Walter M. Sessoms became the first helicopter to fly in the Antarctic. Having proved its capabilities, the initial naval HO3S1 order was followed by subsequent purchases of an additional 42 aircraft in 1948. The Navy equipped several warship classes with HO3S1 utility helos, including aircraft carriers, seaplane tenders, icebreakers, Des Moines-class cruisers, and Iowa-class battleships. By February 1948, the Marine Corps had equipped HMX-1, its first regular Marine Helicopter Transport Squadron, with 6 HO3S1 aircraft. With a passenger load of only 3 lightly dressed persons, the HO3S1 were primarily operated in the utility role by the Marines. For the transport role, an additional 9 tandem rotor Piasecki-built HRP-1 helicopters were later added to the squadron. Eventually, the U.S. Navy would acquire a total of 88 HO3S1 helicopters. 39 additional specialized rescue helicopters were built, as the H-5G, in 1948, while 16 were fitted with pontoons as the H-5H amphibian in 1949. The R-5 had been designated under the United States Army Air Forces system, a series starting with R-1 and proceeding up to about R-16. In 1947, with the start of the United States Air Force, there was a new system, and many aircraft, but not all, were redesignated. The United States Army broke off with its own designation system in the 1950s, resulting in new designations for its helicopter projects. In 1962, under the new Tri-Service system, many Navy and Army aircraft were given the low numbers. Under the 1962 system, the low H numbers were given to new aircraft. The H-5, HO3S1 gained its greatest fame during the Korean War when it was called upon repeatedly to rescue United Nations pilots shot down behind enemy lines and to evacuate wounded personnel from frontline areas. In 1957, the last H-5 and HO3S1 helicopters were retired from active U.S. military service. The S-51 was the first helicopter ever to be delivered to a commercial operator. On July 29, 1946, the first of three aircraft was handed over to the president of helicopter air transport at Sikorsky's plant in Bridgeport, Connecticut. In the United Kingdom, the first scheduled daily helicopter service started in June 1950, between Liverpool and Cardiff using S-51 operated by British.